Ciao comrades, today we are looking at this laptop. It is ultra thin, it has full metal body construction, it has 16 inches FHD Plus IPS LCD screen, it has Core i5 1030 NG7 CPU, Intel Iris Plus built-in GPU, 16GB of RAM, 512GB of storage, large trackpad and actually a decent keyboard. It is made by Blackview Company and the model is AceBook 12. I will put the exact price with discount coupon right now on the screen. I think it should be around 350 British pounds. I've never heard about this CPU, so we're gonna do some benchmarks, plus some gaming and emulation. But first, let's check its build quality. It is very decent. Top, inside and bottom of the laptop are all made out of aluminium. It looks really good. I think they were going for a MacBook look. It is only 18 millimeters thin and it weighs 1.6 kilograms. It has two USB 3.0, one USB 2.0, SD card reader, headphone jack, HDMI out and one USB-C. USB-C is used for charging. They have provided 65 watt fast charger. I feel like there should be two USB-Cs, one for charging and one extra for something else. I have some experience with this Blackview company. They are making these affordable versions of more popular products. I already reviewed two tablets from them and they were both pretty decent. This laptop was also provided free of charge for a review, but they don't have any input on this video. Now let's look at the IPS LCD. It has 16 inches with a resolution 920 by 1200 with 16 by 10 ratio. It has 330 nits of brightness. There are small bezels with 88% screen to body ratio. On top of the bezel, there is a camera and two microphones.
This is the test of the front camera and two microphones. What does it look like and what does it sound like?
The hinge can be opened up to 180 degrees. That means it can lay flat on the table. The colors are nice. Quality of the panel seems to be okay too. It has matte surface, so there aren't many reflections. And the viewing angles are also decent, as you can see from the video footage. I can't get enough of these videos with Slovakian nature. Touchpad or trackpad is large and very usable. According to description, it has 106 centimeters squared. Keyboard feels good. I was writing on it without much issues, without much getting used to. The spacing is okay. There is some travel to the keys and they are very easy to use. There is also a fingerprint scanner. It is built into the power button, so you don't need to write a PIN when you switch on the device. It comes pre-installed with Windows 11 Pro. Setup was as expected. Lot of useless things pushed to me by Microsoft that I had to deny. There are two speakers from the bottom and honestly they are quite weak. I was hoping for something better. I was comparing them to the much cheaper tablet from the same company, Blackview, and the tablet sounded so much better. Not sure why they think putting shitty speakers into the tablet is okay, but it definitely isn't. You be the judge. If I could save time in a bottle, if I okay, now we are moving into the important stuff. Performance. It has Core i5 1030 NG7 CPU with 4 cores and 8 threads. It has 10 nanometers architecture and it was made back in 2020. Base frequency is 1.1 GHz and turbo is up to 3.5 GHz. I was doing a Geekbench 6 test. You can see the results on the screen. Single core 1444, multi-core 3080. I was comparing this score to the laptop that I'm using right now with Intel N95 CPU. And it was higher than that, but it is also more expensive. It has dual channel 16GB LPDDR4 RAM, 512GB of M.2 storage. I was opening the laptop and I could only see the M.2 drive. I haven't seen RAMs, so either they are soldered on the board or they are hidden somewhere deeper. Now, let's check some gaming, shall we? First, I've tried Vita emulation, of course. Drive Girls, upscaled to 2x, with Vulkan backend, was very playable. I was using this DualShock 4 style of controller with touchpad, and to my surprise, it was detected as touch inputs inside of the game. So, for example, next I've tried Wipeout 2048, also upscaled to 2x, and this game requires you to use touch in the menu, so I've just pressed the touchpad and it was working absolutely fine, which caught me a bit off guard. And I gotta tell you, I'm a big fan of it. Same with Uncharted Golden Abyss. It allowed me to control the touch operation with touchpad on the controller. Great feature, let me tell you. The game was running a bit slower because I have upscaled it to 1.5x. It would be performing better at native Vita resolution. Soul Sacrifice was same. Performance would be much better at native Vita resolution because it was also upscaled, but it worked okay with some minor graphical glitches. Next, I've tried PS2 emulation and Black, which is harder to emulate game. I've upscaled it to 2.5x and it was running at full speed. So I've pushed it even further to 3x and there were also no slowdowns. Resident Evil 4 at 3x, there were some slowdowns, so I went down to 2.5x and it was running at full speed. Jak and Daxter, Precursor Legacy, full speed at 2.5x with some minor graphical glitches. Need for Speed Underground 2, full speed upscaled to 3x of original resolution. I know Underground 2 and Resident Evil 4 are also available natively for the PC, but I always emulating them cause it's more like a benchmark to me. And it passed this benchmark test nicely. Shadow of Colossus, one of the hardest to emulate game. There were some slowdowns at 1.75x, so I went down to 1.5x, which was much more stable. Next I've tried PSP emulation, God of War, Ghost of Sparta, upscaled to 4x, running at full speed. Same as Chains of Olympus and Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. PSP emulation was honestly really good. I've tried also one PS3 game, Destroy All Humans, Path of Furon. It was running around 20 FPS, so not at a full speed, but the fan was definitely running at full speed. PS3 emulation was pushing the CPU really hard, so I rather moved to native PC games. I was running them from this handy external SSD, so I didn't need to install anything. Smaller indie games were running absolutely fine. Hades, Cuphead, Yoku's Island Express. Then I've tried something harder, like Assassin's Creed Liberation HD. It was running a bit slower. I lowered some graphical settings and it was running a bit better. Not exactly locked frame rate, but playable. Then I've tried something even harder, Elden Ring, at 1280 by 800. Quality settings at medium and it was running like at 20 FPS, which is kinda slow. And GTA 5 was running at 30 FPS. So I think with majority of indie games you would be absolutely fine, but these harder or more graphically intensive AAA games are not gonna be really playable. I've also tried some Switch emulation. I don't really want to show you much gameplay footage because we all know Nintendo. And I want to avoid every single ninja out there. Okay, let's sum it up. What I like. I like the slim design and full metal body construction. LCD screen is not bad. Battery life was also okay. It has 5000 mAh battery. Keyboard and touchpad were not bad either. I also like the performance. I mean the price to performance ratio. The only thing that was mediocre were the speakers. I feel like these companies really need to start pay attention to speakers because they are necessary for a good experience. This tablet was not designed for emulation or gaming, but as we have seen, it was able to pull off quite a few of them at full speed. It was designed more like for office work or for studying. I was searching for laptops with same CPU and 2020 13-inch MacBook Air popped up. So this is pretty much what they was aiming for. MacBook Air knockoff that is running Windows. If this is something of interest for you, feel free to check it out. You can find a link for it down below. Give this video a like if you enjoyed it. I would like to thank you all for watching. Thanks to members and Patreons for their support. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.